All right, today we're gonna talk about if silence can make a man miss you. And if you stick around until the very end of this video, not only are we going to be describing the psychology of why we believe silence may be the key to getting an ex back or making any man in general miss you, but we're gonna give you real life tips that you can apply to your situation right now and get immediate results. So oftentimes when we're talking about silence in the context of breakup recovery, we're usually talking about the no contact rule. Now, while I will give you the definition for the no contact rule here, I actually want to go a little above and beyond just the no contact rule. We've done a million videos on the no contact rule before. If you don't believe me, just look at my YouTube channel. They are scattered throughout the playlists. I'd like to actually talk a little bit about the psychology of why we believe silence is a key component to making an ex miss you. But first things first, what is a no contact rule? Well, simply put, the no contact rule refers to a period of time where you cut off all conceivable communication with an ex after a breakup. Now, the intent of this tactic should not be used to make your ex miss you, but instead should be used to rebuild your own life so that you outgrow your ex. By doing this, the no contact rule can have the added benefit of making an ex miss you. Now, I want you to hold on to the concept of the no contact rule for a little bit because we are going to circle around at the end of this video and talk about sort of the hidden aspects of the no contact rule and the silence portion of it that we believe is so key to making silence and breakup recovery work. But I think I need to kind of lay a foundation for you so you understand why silence is so important to whatever strategy you're using on your ex. And to do that, we must first understand the psychology of why silence works so well on ex-boyfriends or ex-girlfriends. So the first thing about silence is there's almost an embedded concept of playing hard to get within it. Now, the general tactics of playing hard to get are the following. You have limited availability, you're hard to get hold of, you seek attention but then disregard it. That's a little bit of the hot and cold aspect. You're showing initial interest and then letting it wane. Now, ultimately, the key to playing hard to get is balancing this trade-off between desire and frustration. And the no contact rule does the playing hard to get almost incredibly well for you, but where it gets difficult is this balancing act that I talked about. You have to balance desire with frustration. Now, where does the desirable aspect of the no contact rule come in? Well, one of the things we do know about making exes regret is you have to give them time to regret. So the no contact rule has that embedded in there, especially if you're doing something like a 30-day no contact rule where you're going to ignore your ex in every way imaginable for 30 days straight. That kind of helps with the desire component. And I will actually explain a little bit more about the reactance component to that, but I don't want to get too far ahead of myself. Where it gets difficult is what happens around day 15 when your ex reaches out to you saying, "Why are you ignoring me?" or even expressing their undying love for you and then getting frustrated when you don't respond right away. That's the frustration part of it. So we have always tried to design our no contact rules to keep this scale in mind. You don't want to frustrate your ex so much that they give up, but you also don't want to make yourself too available so that they also give up. You need to kind of hit that scale in the middle. We found that the no contact rule tends to work best if it's done around a 21-day or a 45-day period, depending on your specific situation. So yes, it helps you play hard to get. Hey there, real quick, I wanna say that if you're new to this YouTube channel or you're trying to figure out what you should be doing to get your ex back and you're trying to learn if you even have a chance in your specific circumstance, probably the smartest thing for you to do is actually stop by our website, www.exboyfriendrecovery.com, or take our ex recovery chances quiz that can be found at exboyfriendrecovery.com. Now, if you're watching this on YouTube, taking that free quiz is super easy to do. All you have to simply do is look in the description link below this YouTube video and click on the link you see there. It will take you directly to the quiz where you can fill it out and get an easy answer on what you should be doing going forward and overall what your chances look like in your specific situation. All right, so let's get you back to the video. But another thing the no contact rule does is tap into this concept called reactance. So psychological reactance is basically this theory that states we all have these behavioral freedoms, and when we feel one of those behavioral freedoms is getting threatened or has the potential to be taken away, we often react in a way to try to protect that freedom or get it back. Well, the no contact rule also dives into this concept. This is why we have such a knee-jerk reaction from the people we use it on. So not only is the no contact rule helping you play hard to get by simply ignoring your ex, making yourself less available, but you are also tapping into the reactance part of it. All of this just through doing nothing, just through being silent. So here's how the reactance part works. In your ex's mind, they have you at all times. They feel, you know what, I broke up with her, I'm better than her, they believe this. And then they start thinking, you know what, I can get her back whenever I want. So they try to do the nice thing and just sort of reach out to you and see how you're doing because they have this natural affinity for wanting to find out how you're doing. And when you don't respond, they feel like the ability to talk to you has been taken away, especially after they are consistently getting stonewalled, and then they react. This is why you have those massive blowups where they get really angry or threaten to never talk to you again. This is all a result of reactance. It's also an interesting sign that they still really care a lot about you, and this kind of helps them realize that as well, but you also have to balance it with that frustration aspect, because there is such a thing as them becoming too frustrated. But we've had that worked into the no contact rule if you read any of our massive articles on it. And probably the most undervalued aspect of what silence can do for you after a breakup is that it makes you more unpredictable, and unpredictability raises perceived value. So here's an interesting little thing about our brains. Now, our brains actually love unpredictability because the highs are higher than if we got the desired reward all the time. It helps release dopamine and creates more investment. I am on record multiple times through multiple videos saying that we as human beings are slave to our patterns when it comes to relationships. We often like knowing exactly when things are gonna happen. We talk at the same time every single day. If we aren't talking at the same time every single day, we're informing the other person why we're not talking every single day. And when that pattern gets interrupted, you go crazy. But what's interesting is also, we don't love patterns. One thing that we have found through breakups is a big reason why people break up with each other is that things have become too stale, aka stable, and not adventurous or mysterious enough. On the other hand, if things are too adventurous, mysterious all the time, people will complain that it's not stable enough. So not only do we have to balance a stability and mystery chart, but we also have to learn to be unpredictable from time to time. The other thing is your ex probably has embedded within their brain an idea of how people or exes are supposed to react after a breakup. And when you don't do anything to interrupt that pattern or that internal narrative in your ex's head, guess what happens? They just think, okay, this is just like all the other times. But if you stand out, if you are unpredictable by simply doing nothing, by being silent, being like, you know what, I'll talk to you when I'm ready to talk to you, that is what stands out to an ex. That is what makes them pay attention. That is also not going to win them back 100% of the time. In fact, I would say that won't win them back at all. But what it does is gets them to pay attention and take you more seriously, which is a much better starting point than the other option. Now, I'd like to draw your attention back to the concept of the no contact rule. At the beginning of this video, I defined the no contact rule and I made kind of some controversial statements. Yes, I said the no contact rule is something that you use to ignore your ex. Yes, I said it can make your ex miss you, but I also said something super controversial, and that was the fact that I don't believe you should be using the no contact rule to make an ex miss you. It's a recipe for disaster. We have found when you interview our success stories, people who have gone through our program, successfully gotten their exes back more often than not, these are people who started out the no contact rule with kind of basic intentions of, yeah, I'm gonna make my ex miss me. But it soon evolved into something more powerful for self-growth, and they outgrew their ex by the very end. And by doing that, their ex began to miss them versus someone who goes into the no contact rule with the intent of making an ex miss them, and guess what happens? Their ex doesn't miss them at all because they overplay their hand more often than not. So what am I trying to say here? Well, what I'm saying here is a lot of people who are watching this video and being all excited about, hey, Chris is talking about silence and how silence can make a big difference in making my ex want me back. I want my ex to want me back. Our success stories are saying a different thing. Silence works to make exes want to come back. It won't be the thing that makes them come back. So what's more important isn't the fact that silence is making an ex come back, but what's important is how you use that silence. What are you doing with it? Because if you really think about it, the silence period is almost like a reset button. And if you reset the game and you haven't changed at all, you're probably going to get the exact same result. Now, I'm not saying you need to change your personality or anything like that. What I am saying is you need to be the very best version of yourself. You also need to stop caring about your ex. You need to outgrow them. You need to get to a place emotionally where you're like, okay, whatever. If I don't get them back, I don't get them back. And then coming into a conversation with them after silence, after the no contact rule, you'll find your results are a lot better. But I will tell you one thing that silence is not good for. And silence is not good for clicking that subscribe button below. Silence will really hurt our YouTube channel, so be loud. Let us know in the comments your experiences with silence in the past. Click the subscribe button below and click the like thing. What is that, thumbs up thing on YouTube, so you can help us out with the YouTube algorithm and do your part to get us to the top so we can dominate Google, and then I can say, see, we're awesome. Also, if you haven't, make sure you take the ex recovery chances quiz that I talked about in this video. Doing so is super simple. Just look in the description link below this YouTube video, click the link you see there. It will take you directly to the quiz where you can fill out the information and get an idea of what kind of chance you have of getting your ex back. All right, I'll see you guys next time.